In this video, I'm going to finish mounting the gauge cluster and then hopefully get the wiring panel here built. And then I got to figure out where I want the radio to go. I'm wondering if it's going to go here or... I have no idea really, but I'll figure it out. So the way I built the template was just use the a cardboard stencil and kind of taped pieces around it to contour the gauge cluster so that you know, it looks as aesthetically pleasing as possible. And yeah, so I just Sharpie outlined it, found the center of the gauge cluster with the center of the boat, center of the dash, and just line them up that way. So here is mounting that. Alright, that was easily the second worst thing that I've ever done in my life. If metal filing were an Olympic sport, I would definitely get a bronze. That was absolutely awful. But it looks real decent. Yeah, so that's done. The dash is starting to come together. And the switch panel for the accessories is gonna go right here. And then I'm thinking the radio located between the two on the right-hand side, or I might do it low, or right here. I don't know, I have no idea. Regardless, that's done. So yeah, on to the next thing. But wait, there's more. It's not done. I still gotta drill the holes so that it can actually bolt in there. Cause I don't need it to fall out while I'm driving. So the holes are next. All right, so now that I've cut this big ass mushroom into my dashboard, I need to figure out how to get these holes aligned up. So I figure the easiest way, instead of trying to put it behind there and then center punch it, then drill it from the backside, is to just put this on here and then hope that I cut this out symmetrically and then center punch these holes here and then drill it out. So let's hope this actually works. All right, so that turned out pretty well. Once I have the boat wrapped, it all of these little blemishes, you'll no longer be able to see. The dash is gonna be black, the windscreen is gonna be black, and then the rest of the boat, the exterior is gonna be a dark charcoal metallic. So I'd say this is looking good. The ignition switch, turn that on, that turns on. If I wanna start the boat. Yeah, so, okay. Probably gonna start on the through-hole fittings.
for all the water lines, the bilge, and the cable glands for when, well, with the current pandemic, I don't know if the cable's gonna show up anytime soon, but I can start chipping off little things off the block until then. So yeah, I might start on the accessory panel, or I might start on the through-hole fittings. I'm not sure yet. Gonna do some wiring management because this looks like a catastrophe under there. So actually I haven't got under there to see what it looks like. So I should be able to tuck, actually, tuck a good bit of this under that bracket, keep it clean looking, and then probably have to mount a tab somewhere, weld it along the way so that I actually have a hanger for the rest of the wiring harness. So probably loom these up together like so. All right, I'll get started on that.
All right, so all of the essential wiring harness is done. So for any accessories that I run, that'll be in a subsequent video. But for the time being, the gauge is done, the ignition switch, the start and stop buttons, those are done. The wiring harness underneath there, I welded tabs so that it can be ran up underneath the gunnel. The cluster F of wiring that is right there, that'll be addressed once I have the bulkhead in here, where I can actually pin it up correctly and then separate the wires and kind of make it look clean. But yeah, for this video, I'd say it is done. Just got the garage cleaned up, and I think the next set of tasks, although I want to start on the bulkhead, realistically needs to be the water line routing, the bilge line routing, and the drain line routing. So I gotta drill some holes through there, and I have 5-inch or 5/8-inch pipe for the OD, and I'm not sure what the ID is, but I'm gonna basically weld on, go to a buddy's house and TIG weld a barb at the end of this, and then use the lathe here to build a washer that goes around the outside here so that I can essentially TIG weld it to the boat and make it look real clean, so it has a flange to weld onto, so we're not just trying to use the thin walled metal that's here to get it to adhere to the boat, because that might not work so well and it might not be as strong. So yeah, that concludes this video. The next one will probably be at my buddy's house, so that's this.